Magandang araw sa inyong lahat.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening po sa lahat ng nakikinig po.
Hello to all our viewers from here and around the world.
Napakaganda na ating talentayman ngayong hapon ito.
Isang mainit na pagbati po sa inyong lahat.
Well, friends,
welcome to the Bridges Show.
I'm very happy to be here. And I think it should be a really interesting and fun topic.
What are the things you want to learn? So I want to take it from there and then I listen to them.
Meron po silang mga mithiin upang maging makabuluhan pa ang pagiging Katoliko. Lalong-lalo na sa susunod na henerasyon.
Sa akin po, sa mga kabataan, ano, use competence, no, as a basis.
In real life, hindi naman talaga tayo tumitigil sa buhay. Kailangan talaga tuloy lang ang buhay kahit anong challenges natin.
Palawan, Cebu, Baguio City, Atty. Dwight, pati La Union. So we are saying that revenge travel is real.
Mas kailangan natin na i-share ang hiwaga ng sinyo sa mga tao.
Food and health should go hand in hand. So yan ang gusto namin paratingin sa gobyerno.
If you will just devote your life to change, hindi ka yayaman sa pera, pero yayaman ka sa tao.
Siyempre, ang pinakamaganda po naman sa ating universidad ay yung talagang natuturuan po tayo kung paano maging mabuting tao.
Happy anniversary to Bridges! Here at Bridges, we build bridges of faith, bridges of hope, and bridges of love.
The life of a professional singer is a symphony of hard work, creativity, and perseverance. Every note sung and every performance delivered is the result of relentless practice and a deep commitment to the craft. As singers navigate through rehearsals, recordings, and tours, they embody the essence of resilience and artistry. While the life of an international singer can be glamorous and fulfilling, offering the opportunity to connect with billions of fans worldwide, it also comes with its sets of challenges that require resilience, dedication, and careful lifestyle management. In this week's episode of Bridges, let's look into the life of a professional singer and the challenging road they face to have a rewarding and successful career. We will explore their world excuse me po, with our special guest, Mr. Elijah Pamarian. Excuse me. This is Mary Elaine Molina, and I am also a graduate of Bachelor of Music, major in Music Education, voice emphasis, of course, at our dear University of San Diego. As a student, I was often part of the dance list and had been an active member of numerous organizations that honed my talents and skills as a teacher, singer, performer, and conductor. Together with my co-officials at the Conservatory of Music Student Council, we had been awarded the St. Dominic de Guzman Award in 2011 for our outstanding contribution to the university. I was also a former member and active alumna of the world-renowned chorale ensemble I Musica Pella, and actually I'm very happy to share with you that they will represent our country next year in the European Grand Prix because they won the Grand Prix prize this month in Debrecen, Hungary. And I took part in the 2012 Busan International Chorale Festival and Competition and won the Grand Prix in Busan, South Korea, together, of course, with I Musica. I also had the opportunity to perform and be a part of the second Sing Philippines Youth Choir and performances at the Cultural Center of the Philippines under the baton of the conductor of the Madrigal Singers, singer Mr. Mark Anthony Carpo. And of course, with my talents and skills, I was also able to make a name of myself in the field of education and choral conducting. I was awarded as the best conductor at the Space and Carols 2016 by the Lyceum of the Philippines Cavite. At present, I am the conductress of the Sisters of Mary of Banu Corazon Choir and the church-based choirs Angelico Voce Choral, Angelico Voce Children's Choir, and the newly formed Erin's Chorale of the St. Vincent. I will be your host for today. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. This episode today is brought to you by the UST Conservatory of Music Alumni and Association Incorporated and the UST Alumni Association. Before we continue, I invite you to remember to like and share our show and subscribe to our UST Tomasian Alumni Community YouTube channel and follow our Facebook page. Napakaganda talaga ang conversations natin ngayong hapon. Meron po tayong sikat na panauhin na magdadala po sa atin sa makulay na mundo ng profesional na mga awit. Walang iba kung hindi si Mr. Elajo Pamarang. Hi, sir!
Hello, magandang araw or to say good afternoon sa inyong lahat. My name is Elajo. Ako po ay, I'm very happy to be here.
Yes. Alright, of course, ipapakilala ko po kayo. I'm very excited to introduce Sir Elajo. So, Sir Elajo Pamaran is a versatile crossover singer-actor based in Berlin, born and raised in the Philippines. Studied in University of Santo Tomas Conservatory of Music, major in voice under the one and only Maestra Irma Potensyal. His performances have ranged from the classical to pop to rock and theater musicals, bringing him to different countries all over the world, including Indonesia, Singapore, Japan, New York, Spain, Switzerland, Austria, Sweden, and of course, Germany. In the German premiere of Miss Saigon, he played in the ensemble and performed the role of Puri. In essence, Elajo was seen in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat as Benjamin, and later played the title role of Joseph. He was also part of the world premiere of Disney's Wagner von Notre Dame in Berlin. Also in Berlin, did the role of Mackemesser or Mack the Knife in the Tripany Opera and appeared with various bands. Elajo, for the most part, have been doing vocal coaching, concerts in Belize, Philippines, and New York, and on the sides, thus helped bring to different charitable institutions for the greater good. Before heading to Europe, he was actively involved with CCP's Tanghalang Filipino musicals such as El Filibusterismo, Filipina Circa, Florante at Laura, Himala the Musical, Ang Pagpatay kay Juana, Carmen as Don Jose. Performed as well for Rigoletto and La Boheme as a dancer in his earlier career. He has long been working with the AIDA Entertainment for creative concepts and performing artists. Dear friends, it is my job to have with me today in Bridges, again, Mr. Elajo Pamaran. Welcome to Bridges, sir!
Hello! Hello to everybody! Kumusta kayo dyan?
Yan! So, kumusta naman tayo sa comment section? So, kindly comment there. How are you and where are you now? And yes, so, sir, I am very excited to be with you today. Kasi as a singer din, isa yan sa mga dream ko, yung mga nakita ko sa stage. And then when I knew that it was you and I read your profile, oh my gosh. Like, nakaka-inspire agad. So, tayo pong mga audience, especially Filipinos, pag nakakita tayo ng mga singer or dancers or artists, minsan mapapaisip ka eh, paano kaya nagsimula itong taon na to? Paano kaya yung humble beginnings niya? So, sir, may I ask, as a child, mahilig ka na po ba talagang kumanta? And can you tell us about your journey into music and what inspired you to become a singer?
Well, it's a long story, but to start off, my family is not really musicians, but my father loves to hear music. So, he plays a lot of like different kinds of music to us, and then when I reached age of six, we were forced to learn piano. So we have like a weekend piano class. Our pianist, our piano teacher comes to our house for classes. And of course, during the weekend, my dad is always proud. Oh, my three kids are performing for you guys. You know, it's always like, it's a typical, I think in every Filipino family in nighttime, it's important to have a piano in the house as part of the you know, as part of the living room. So it's a part of entertainment and pride for every family that one could play piano or guitar, and then eventually like violin, also like electric organ and stuff like that. So I tried all of that, and then eventually I think I was very playful and quite lazy, and I feel like that I just want to sing. So I've been singing at an early age on the top of the coffee table, entertaining the guests of my dad. And then eventually my dad pushed me to do more classes. So I was studying voice class in some music school near our place, and then I did summer workshop in UP. Unfortunately, my father died before I finished high school. And then that was really hard. And from that point of time, I decided to be a musician to uplift my family spirit. So I got more into singing. And then the story was before I got into UST, I'm supposed to study theology. Last minute, my heart is saying, like, you know, I want to do music and continue my studies. So during that enrollment, I went to the Conservatory of Music, and I was talking to Dina Tabog and said, like, I'm already enrolled in another course, but I really, my heart tells me to come here and audition, and I want to apply for scholarship and all this stuff, you know. Eventually, I made it, and then it all went there from that uh-huh. time onwards. Everything was just like in total alignment.
Oh my gosh, nakakatuwa po yung ano na yun, no? Yung story na yun. Kasi talagang naka-enrolled na kayo sa ano? Sa ibang college. And then talagang yung puso niyo talagang tinitibok ay pagkanta or ang musika. Oh my gosh, it's really nice to know these kinds of stories. Thank you so much for sharing that. Sir, may I know, kayo po ang panganay or bunso? Or sa
I have two, we're three siblings. And I'm the only son. So when my father died at the age of 14, I took over my family's responsibility from cooking, from, you know, because everybody was devastated. So I felt like, you know, it was my duty to take care of my family. So that's quite hard because, like, it's a lot of difficulties during that time financially and all this stuff, but it didn't stop me. So I was studying as well as working at the same time. So I'm doing a lot of odd jobs, a lot of extras on doing film, doing gigs, doing commercials, at the same time going to school. So,
My gosh, that was so, my gosh. Ang sipag niyo, sir. Ito, sir. Nung nakapasok na kayo or before pa kayo nakapasok sa UST, who were some of your biggest musical influences?
Kasi during that time, the OPM is just flourishing. So when I talk about the OPM, let's talk about the OPM because, you know, we have to.
Yes, sir.
I'm very nationalistic in that case.
Wow.
Basil Valdez was like my idol. Basil was like, he was the first time who he won the Metro Pop in U, and then eventually also Gary Valenciano and Martin Rivera, Pain naman yung kay Martin Rivera from. Gary Valenciano's first song that became like kind of like pop, yung Di Na Natuto.
Yeah.
So all this time yung time luma na, no? But before that, I'm really, because I started singing, I joined the choir when I was young. And I know that I wasn't really thinking that I have the talent, but I'm very eager. I wanted to be active. So I was with a choir in school at the age of 7. And then I was like super soprano, you know. And I thought I could be like a countertenor because I love, you know, I like listening to Purcell's countertenor compositions, and I sing them. But on the process, a lot of things going on. My voice is also kind of like, I have a big voice and a high voice, so I was kind of ridiculed also when I was young because it's totally a different sound. But it didn't bother me, and I was just. When you're driven, it doesn't really bother you. And then I started to build my self-confidence through music.
Uh-huh.
Music was actually the best, was my sanctuary, because I didn't really have much friends that time. when I was young, I didn't have the crazy young childhood because I was responsible at the age of 14. So when I discovered music, that was my kind of like alter ego. I can be somebody yeah. else and sound.
Yes, sir. Yeah. And then, ano na tayo, sir? Fast forward, balik tayo sa nung nakapasok na kayo sa conservatory. So,
okay, so
what? Eh, sorry, sir.
No, okay, go ahead, Kaja. Yeah. Yeah.
What role did the USC Conservatory have in your career?
When I came to the USC Conservatory of Music, I was really quite worried because, you know, there's a lot of my batch. They're mostly piano majors, are really, really okay. outstanding. And then the singers that I knew, because I had already one person who I want to be like when I was when that's when I first came and I saw him. Abdul Kandao was
Sir Abdul.
Yeah. And you have the same teacher. So, yeah. So I want to be like this guy, you know, because he's confident and then he's the favorite yeah. of Tita Irma and he's been doing so many things. So eventually I befriend him. We became good friends until now.
Yeah.
And then you know, actually Tita Irma was the strictest of all because sometimes she throws the book outside, go out.
Uh-huh. Or
sometimes she calls my mom and telling, "Hello, Mrs. Pamaran, can you tell Elijah if he's not attending the class, papupulis ko siya." You know, so and every time she was really very, very strong, and the training and if you have a weak heart or a weak spirit, you'll quit. A lot of my batchmates quit yeah. because they couldn't stand her kind of teaching. She's very yeah. old school, but her personality helped me to cope with all this difficult reality yeah. life. You know, like the rejection, building up yourself, and presenting yourself. Because Tita Irma is the epitome of a perfect artist. You know, she
yeah.
comes with a bearing, with the way she dress up, the way she talks, her personality.
Diva.
It's just like intimidating.
Yeah,
and all of us were like scared of her when we were starting. Eventually, I realized she was just doing that to prepare us for our future. Because if you're being pampered, oh, you're good, and you know, being yes. Being like making you feel better, then you sort of like build that confidence in a different direction. So yeah. in the beginning, he already imposed and implemented rejection. Hurtful comments, she's yeah. crying you like friend.
Sir, so totoo pala. So even before, strict na si ma'am. Kasi I was able sick, to enter the conservatory and she was still there. And then yun nga, yung mga kabatch ko na teacher siya, talagang, mga kwento na, ako, super sir, ayan na major ko na mamaya, ayoko na, may mga ganun sila.
No, pero alam mo talaga, ano, we need the kind of, teacher like for me kasi she helped me a lot. I know our job, our profession is a difficult job
yeah.
and school is really important to prepare yourself, and it's not about theory, it's not about learning the songs alone, but you have yeah. to build this personality, you have to build yeah. stamina, and also you have to face all this criticism because like that's if you're not that strong, if you're not a strong person, you'll just quit and give up easily.
Yeah. In a way, sir, no, I can say that Ma'am Irma really prepared you in the real world.
It's really like funny. She loves her student.
Yeah.
And eventually when later on she dedicated all this, she's being thankful about the students that, you know, worked with, that she trained, and she put our names and put my name. So I'm really, really flattered that she included me in that kind of like, dedication. And there's a time because I'm also ahead of my time because during that time, like I need to find work. So we're concentrating only with the singing, so because I need to learn more with movement, and so that's why I got into the ballet Philippines, and then Filipino. And then one time I'm performing for the Cordy Ballet in La Boheme or something, and then she came there, like she talked to me like, "Elijo, ano mang gusto mo sa career mo? Magba-ballet dancer ka ba o gusto mo maging singer?" Ganon. Ma'am, I'm gonna be a singer. Don't worry.
Yes, and speaking of singing, sir, so what inspires you most to sing?
You know, for me, my ano eh, singing for me is a sanctuary, and people don't really realize like having this talent is not only a gift, but it's also a responsibility, because music puts things together. It helps you express yourself. It helps you connect to people. It's a powerful instrument. Sabi nga ni St. Augustine, when you're praying, singing is twice praying.
Yes.
Because you're involving your entire being. You know, your body, your spirit, your you know, everything.
Yeah. Sir, are you also a songwriter?
I would not not know. But because I have some songs that I'm really working right now, but until it's published, and then I will say I am a songwriter. I've been writing a lot ever since, but I'm working with some materials now with some of my musician friends, and then hopefully, I mean, my deadline is long overdue, because like I have to do it before my voice sort of like change. So hopefully, it'll come out soon.
We will be waiting for those songs come out. And sir, speaking of songwriting and then singing, in terms of creativity process, what does your creativity process look like when working on new music or preparing for a performance?
It all varies, because like my job now is very stressful, so you have to be very quick. But in general, like, preparation is really important. Before you do your performance, you have to know your materials by heart. You make research. You watch, or I do like watch a lot of performances, and then I update myself on what's happening. And I have also friends who we sort of do like a clinic. So I perform, and then we analyze sound. You know, like if I'm back here, I know I have my contemporaries from the USA, and then we sort of like discuss things. You know. To enhance, because like we say, music is like it's not fixed science, and it also changes, and also the sort of like a progress in
yes,
the time.
Sir.
So
yes,
if I compare the music that I was learning, well, let's say 40 years ago, it's already it's sort of like mutated into a bigger scope, and it's never gonna it's still gonna change.
Yeah.
Better. Yeah.
I totally agree, sir. Kasi parang music is like technology din. Talagang it progresses po talaga, eh, no? So, through time, nag-i-dibash.
One thing good about our career, like, you know, especially with the pandemic, you know, all this AI, all this computer stuff, you cannot equal a live performance or, you know, with all these things. So, we always have the advantage. But the thing is, like for example, in the Philippines, it's hard to make it as a performer, as a singer, or an actor, if you don't have proper connection, and you know, if you're not putting yourself out. So the best things also, like I was always telling everybody, that you have to create your own work. You have to always update yourself and not always wait for opportunity, because the opportunity is now. The opportunity is always like on how you take it. If you allow yourself to wait, then you're gonna miss the opportunity. So you always have to be there whenever needed.
Yes. And since you have been like singing in musicals, of course the music there or the songs there was composed by other people. Siyempre pa, you may be singing somebody else's work, song, or composition, but how do you make it your own?
Yeah, like as a performer, it's important that whatever you do, you sort of like believe in it, and then you have to, everything that comes out from your mouth should be coming from you. So you have to connect the truth in what you're doing. You have to really digest on what the word is telling. You know, you have to tell the story, and that story comes from your experience or from your understanding. Because if you try, like, there's always the problem when we always watch something and we hear something, we tend to imitate, which is normal, you know, we hear the sound. But that's why we need to practice a lot and we figure out what is, how do we adopt that, how to make it our own, so to make it more exciting. Or else the people just buy or listen to Spotify and listen, it's the same thing. But if you have something exciting, or you put a different color, the whole thing would change. Especially now, like for example, I'm talking about Little Shop of Horror. Little Shop of Horror was composed and created a long time ago. And now because of this social awareness, for example, in New York, they casted a gender, a non-binary character as a lead role instead of a typical female singer. So, and then nag-evolve ding story. So the story becomes more creative. And then now in New York, they casted a colored lead. Normally, it's always like a white person.
Yes.
So nag-change, nag-vary yung ano. So nagiging exciting kasi you know, there's a lot of things that if you perform before, for example, if you do like King and I, marami mga racial slurs and ano, mga parang, now if you say that, it's not appropriate. And then when I work now with a lot of people, they say like, we don't want to sing this song because the song is, it, I don't believe in the song anymore. It's not appropriate in these times. So may mga ganong factors na quite tricky, but going back, it's how you, that's why it's art, you know, you sort of awaken the people's mind and reaction. So doesn't mean that you have to believe it, but you have to create that kind of, the reaction is the most important thing. When people are triggered to do a reaction, then you made your job. But yeah, it's a long discussion. It's gonna be another discussion.
Na-excite tuloy ako, sir. Hindi po part ng ano, ng program or ng script, pero I'm excited to hear and watch you. Maybe we can request later for Sir Eladio to like sing just a few lines. Na-excite tuloy ako na
I can play some videos maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I said it's like ako, like I'm particular when I'm singing. It has to have a good sound, like now, because it doesn't bring justice to the to the song. So yun yung hard for the live ano eh, sa live. Yeah. Because we did during the pandemic also like concerts. So minsan may delay or the connection is not good. So you have to prepare everything and make sure that. Because whatever you do, because you can take it back eh.
I do understand.
Social media, you know, when you do something, people will always say something. No matter how good or bad you are, there's always like a criticism, an analyzation, chugi, whatever, you know.
Yeah. Sir, in connection to what you said about you, that tell the story, tell the truth of the music or the song, how do you choose the themes or messages that you want to convey through your song?
Sometimes I was given material that I cannot really choose. For example, for work, it's already given. For example, for musical, there's some songs that you just have to learn it. But in that aspect, if you're doing a musical production, you try to understand the purpose of the story itself, and then you sort of like analyze also the character. What's the character's connection to another person, or what's the main theme you're talking about, or you have to understand yung the entire, like in acting, you have to smell, you smell it, you have to feel it, you have to basically at that moment to and then by this process, then you can convey the reality, or you create that kind of we call that like in German, it's just echt, like pure, like it's just pure. Like because sometimes, like when we're performing, we tend to think before, okay, I'm gonna make this like this. So, not to change yung color. So, but if you know before you perform, ano yung purpose ng song, on how do you want to convey? Because mag-iba lahat. Any song can change. A happy song can be a sad song. Sad can be a happy song. It can be a sarcasm. It could be funny. So it also like depends on how you interpret. Kaya it's exciting. You can always like create and play with it.
Yes, kaya po, ano, parang binalikan ko yung sinabi nyo kanina, preparation. Kailangan talaga prepared tayo.
You have to prepare, and also like ibang factors kasi you have to also follow the direction. You can you cannot just also create something. You have to have an open mind, especially if you're doing a musical or production that you can sort of like connect and it works for that process. Kasi kung magka-create ka and then you don't want to listen, then it doesn't work that way. You have to have it's a teamwork when you're doing a musical project or anything. It's important that you listen na ano ba yung kailangan natin, what do we need to portray, how do you want to do it, and then you adjust all the time.
Collaborative work.
Mm-hmm.
Ngayon sir, nakikita namin na syempre yung success and all the fame, but of course behind the scenes hindi namin alam yung mga nangyayari syempre sa mga personal life then and all. So what were some of the biggest challenges you faced breaking into the national and the international music scene? And how did you break, sir, into the international music scene?
Well, in general, it's always hard, like, you know, to audition. Because audition is, to get into a production, it's always audition. No matter how good you are, or it's also on the mercy of the one who's auditioning you. So there's always a type. So I auditioned to a lot of productions and I got a lot of rejections as well. But it doesn't stop there. You have to just continue auditioning and never give up. Kasi minsan, ay, gusto ko yan. But sabi mo parang perfect na sa akin to. But hindi ka kinuha. You know, you sang well, you did well. You're already there. Like, you know, I have a lot of projects. I had workshop already. But at the end, okay, we'll choose the other guy or something like that.
Yeah,
for example, I'm supposing one story is when I'm supposed to do Starlight Express. They got me because of the singing and acting.
Yeah.
Tapos like, kasi may mga factors eh. Eh kasi it's a physical thing, it's the roller skates. So So may mga ganung factors. So parang okay, Elijah, we'll just extend the contract of the lead guy. Ganun. And then eventually, okay, I cannot you know, do anything about it because that's a decision. Yeah. So even though you tried your best, hindi pa rin siya ano eh. Like, ako, I love Les Miserables. You know, I always audition, but during that time, they don't hire Asians. Yung look, yung mga ganun.
Oh, yes.
So yung mga ganun. Nag-start lang yung ano, yung color, call it color blind or color freedom nung when I auditioned for Joseph, because like my role is a white role, yung Benjamin, or being Joseph alone. Mm-hmm. But nag-start na mag-open yung ano, yung possibilities. So I was lucky because like in auditions, for example, for international, yung auditions kasi hindi lang sa Germany, they go to New York, they go to they go to London, they go to Australia to cast this production. So you just have to prepare. Tsaka sometimes it's really, if it's meant to be, it's meant to be. So yung preparation, you just have to be always prepared. Like even if I'm not auditioning, like when I was in Germany, because it's an international scene, I take classes. I take German class. Oh. I have a German phonetic class on my personal time. I have a bel canto Italian singing vocal coach. And I have a Broadway vocal coach. And I have a phonetic coach. And I have an acting coach. And I take ballet class and movement class to prepare yourself. Kasi in my time, kasi hindi pa, they don't really do a lot of movements like in the Philippines during that time. So ngayon kasi, ano na eh, a lot of people are like prepared. You know, they can dance, they can sing. But before, you have to really find a way to do that. So aside from that, you have to always prepare your monologue. So may mga kasi mga auditions like I'm talking about the international scene. You have to do a German monologue without an accent. So if you pass that, then you can go to the next audition, which is the singing. So if you pass that, then you go to the movement class or movement or dance.
So hello, sir. I'm back. Yes? Sorry. Yeah. I think it's the poor connection. There. Yeah. Yes.
Talaga ano siya sa palaging kailangan palaging tawag niya parang Boy Scout, laging handa. You have to may bawang ka palagi. You have to prepare. You have to know your material. Saka you cannot just sing any song for a production because it has to fit the style. Like, for example, you cannot sing anything operatic in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat kasi it's a major kind of like pop. So I have to study away because like that during that time I'm doing Miss Saigon. So nawalan ako ng low notes kasi puro high notes yung kinakanta ko.
Okay.
I have to take class yung ganun. Like for example, yung international audition for Hunchback, yung the Glock for Notre Dame. They're looking for high singers and actors and dancers. Sabi ko, okay, kaya ko to high singers. And so I was training with my bel canto. Sabi ko, I have to always practice. So I stretched my range to E flat.
Ooh.
And then they're looking for a high E flat singer, just one.
Mm-hmm.
So yung time na yon, I auditioned for that. I did prepare, I did some workshop audition. But I didn't finish the audition. But I was really prepared but because I was called back to work. And I was upset. Sabi niya na ako, di ko na kumakuha. When I came back to another city to do the Hunchback, to the Joseph, Elijah, yeah. You're hired. They got you. So, talagang sabi ko, shit, sorry. Oh my God, sabi ko, finally, kasi the production creative process is in New York. So, yeah. We're in New York for several months. I was working together with Alan Menken, James Lapine, and Steven Schwartz. And, you know, it's amazing when you're working with these big people. They're the most simple person in down to earth. Like, say, hey, Elijah, like Anne Meng say, like, what do you think of this number? You know, yung talagang you get over James Lapine or Steve.
Yeah.
The nicest person. Even if I see them now, they still remember. Mm-hmm. Oh, Elijah, how is Germany? Or something like that. You know, they, so, yung ganun. So, sa Philippines, ganun din. You have to just be prepared kasi nga, yung every musical is a different type.
Yeah.
So, choosing the right materials is always important. So, you have to prepare a lot of materials para pag nandun ka, meron kang ma-change mo yung mga materials mo.
Yes. And, sir, of course, we already know that you have, like, performed with different characters in different, of course, in musicals. So, can you share, sir, a moment in your career that you consider your greatest achievement?
I would say the greatest work was working for the Kurzweil Ensemble with the Berlin Ensemble in Berlin for the Three Penny Opera. Say the Three Penny Opera is a Brecht. It's in Berlin. And I'm the only Asian and also all of them are German speaking.
Wow.
And that was 2000. So nilalagnat ako every day kasi parang sabi ko, how do I manage? Because I'm doing a musical on the side, and I'm doing also this. Kasi, and then the role is hard kasi you're doing the lead role and then you're surrounded by all these German Berliners and performing in Berlin.
Yeah.
For me talaga parang hindi ako natutulog kasi talaga yung I was really learning the text. Aside from that, the phonetics, tapos yung iba pa yung, it's a difficult one. Tapos, and then okay na yon. Then I learned we did the directing. Tapos very modern yung theater, so we were performing in a fabric. We call it like fabric is it's an old factory. So tapos ang backup ni ang ano ko instruments are brass band. So it's a totally so it's a totally different very modern yung mga pag-direct.
And it is quite challenging ba, sir? Kasi di ba, brass is malalakas eh.
Aside from that, diba? Yung projection mo na.
Yes.
Tapos yung language. Kasi that's 2000 or 2000, I'm just like six years sort of, you know. And then I'm doing a really heavy brushed material. And it's one of those strong materials and a popular one in Berlin. So, sabi ko, I have to do well, or at least I have to make sure that I'm saying the right words and mga ganun. But it's hard. Para ako nilalagnat every day when you're learning this stuff, you know. So aside from learning the music, learning the language, yung you're surrounded by real, you know, ako lang non-speaking or an Asian part. And when I did that, you know, I felt like it's very, very emotional kasi parang the respect of my colleagues and then was really we couldn't imagine like how you do it.
Yes.
I thought because like if you're driven, you can do anything. And so it's already I can attest to that. Yes. Like my dream to get out of the country is like I want to do a musical production. So Miss Lekmo was the subject of Miss Lekmo. I came there. I was first year college, auditioned for Miss Saigon. Sabi sa akin nung Nick McKenzie, like, can you come back next? Because I was like 17 or 18. Can you come back for the next one? Because I was really young. And then, tapos yung pianist ko pa doon is my contemporary, bless him. Si Gary Garcia played for me that time. He was a piano major. And then they called me again for Canada. And Canada, I was hired for Canada. But eventually, they only took two guys. And then they trimmed it down. And then he thought, Lajo, can you come back for the German production? Sabi ko, it's the third time already. Parang, okay, I'll go. And then I got the German production. I was offered to do the German production or Australian production at the same time. But I decided when I stepped in Germany, so I'll stay here. I think the career and my is much there's more potential. So since then, while everybody's having fun, while working in the evening, I took classes. I went to the state school for phonetics, languages. Tapos I'm taking a lot of classes because I want to get. I said when you finish a contract, you have to leave the next day back to your original place of stay. So I was able to manage to get a new production before I ended my contract.
So I can say that you found your place. Kasi ang dami nyo nang napuntahan na magbansa, pero nung nandun
yun na time sa Germany. Sabi ko, Germany is great for artists, you know, the insurance, health insurance. Ganun talaga ako eh, parang health insurance, stability.
Yeah, syempre, no? Stability na tayo. Pag,
sabi
ano.
Ko, sige, I'm gonna really try to find 6 straight years na meron akong job. And during that time, nagbo-boom lahat, puro premier mga productions eh. So I was getting all the jobs. It was very good.
Yes. And of course, sir, nakapunta na kayo sa iba't ibang bansa. Syempre, iba yung cultural experiences. So, may I know how, yes, ito nga, sir, how has performing in different countries influenced you as an artist? And can you describe any unique experiences or memorable moments from your international tours?
Well, to start with, first time in Germany was very difficult. As I was saying before, we studied languages ahead of time, but we were in the city that is with a different dialect, which is the Schwäbisch dialect. So we totally don't understand what they're saying. So I have to struggle with that. And syempre yung aside from the language is the cold, you know, the food in the winter time, yung mga ganun, it gets depressing. But since we have a strong Filipino group, we were able to manage in the beginning. And then eventually, you know, the respect from other because we have like American and German colleagues, they have so much respect because we were prepared when we came there. For me, like my experience, like when I was like working on Broadway, it's more challenging because it's a fast-paced city, and then because it's overwhelming. Because when I was rehearsing in this place called 680, that's where they do the creative production for Chorus Line, for Cats, for all this. And then when you're going to the building, you see all these mga big stars from Broadway, or you see Glitter, so yung mga ganun, American Ballet Company. So so it's overwhelming. And then but they're very you know, it helps you to to improve yourself more. Kasi iba eh, like iba klase yung when you're rehearsing in on Broadway. For example, okay, 10 o'clock is our rehearsal. Mm-hmm. People are there 9 o'clock, warm up, ready to fight. So pag rehearsal, 10 o'clock, full 1000% dahil ko pa yung live performance na yung talagang you're really giving everything. So wala, hindi uso yung you're doing your marking, singing wise, everything is full out. Everything is just like, so talagang grabe yung I've learned so much from that, you know, yung being prepared. Talagang you push your limit.
Yeah. Iba yung discipline, sir, no? Iba sa atin. Hindi naman sa pag-ano, pero iba yung discipline when it comes to, you know, other countries talaga.
Yeah, like, I must say, I've learned a lot in Germany, the punctuality. On time.
Yes.
Punctuality. Like when you say, okay, let's rehearse at 10 o'clock, ganun din. Everybody's ready na yung an hour before people are warming up, and then 10 o'clock will start. And then when it finishes 5, it's 5. Same thing in New York. Pag tapos na, kahit na in the middle of ano, in the middle of the, okay, 5 o'clock out. Tapos na. Uh-huh. Even with the orchestra, finish.
Talaga, on the dot talaga.
On the dot talaga. Kaya talagang you get inspired. Tsaka, the good thing about being outside the country, I was able to watch a lot of productions. Mm-hmm. Not only with opera, musicals, modern dance, live performances, art galleries. Kasi it helps you build your imagination, your knowledge. And like for me, I like watching people. I go to a cafe in every place, stay there for 2-3 hours writing stuff, and then you just meet people.
Yeah.
There's a lot of space for creativity. I've been writing a lot since 1996. Compiling things, and my dream is to make it like a book or a musical.
Wow!
Something like that, you know.
Very creative talaga, sister.
Pero pag marami kang pwedeng gawin.
Yes. Sir, one of the things I admire you most is yung bumabalik pa rin kayo dito sa Pilipinas.
You have to share.
Yes, and speaking
like, for me kasi important is like you share your knowledge of what you learned from. So in the first few years, I think since I was there in 1999, every year I come back. So I have like 3 months I do production in Tanghalan, where I do trumpets, or I did also one in repertory a long time ago. It's nice to have young people, and then you're there and you tell some stories, and then you give them your energy. Parang it's fulfilling. Parang yung purpose mo kasi for me like my personal gains kasi when I'm working or it never came into my head about achieving all these things. Yung, parang it's always important to be on your grounds, on your toes, and just to connect with people. A lot of people do change when they get this kind of like status, but that's a choice. Ako, I try to keep as simple as you have to keep the humility and then the kindness. You have to be kind. You also have to always be a tool for people to get inspired, especially the age experience is really good for younger people. And they can learn from that.
And for sure, sir, nagkaroon in a way ng cultural growth in terms of music. Yung mga taong nakasama nyo, na-sharean nyo ng knowledge of your experiences nyo in other countries. Ayan, sir, we only have, kung pwede lang habaan pa, pero ito na nga, sir. Siyempre, besides your life sa ibang bansa, can you share with us, sir, the regular day now of Mr. Eladio?
Okay, if I'm doing a work, meron akong routine. Like, I wake up first, I do my journal. I've been doing my journal for more than 30 years. Yeah. 28 years. So I write my journal, I put all my thoughts unedited. Like, it's just like, words of thoughts. And then after that, I do my prayers and then my Thanksgiving at the end of that. So when I start my day, lahat ng mga energies ko that was carried the night before, it's already out. So I'm ready out of that, medyo you're calm down. And then I always do my stretching. I do my stretching, I do my exercise. And then it's important to always do exercise. Especially when you're getting old. And then I do a lot of walks, and then if I spare time, I try to see what's if there's like performance, if I'm not performing, or if I can watch a rehearsal. And then I listen to music, I try to see like what songs I can learn. But it's always like there's always something to do.
And then learning talagang
unending. You just like you mingle with young people, it's also important.
Sir, I do agree.
Kasi like ngayon, like when I'm here, I'm so out of touch or so luma with my stats. So when I always like ask my niece, my nephews, or the young people, how they do the task or yung mga yung mga style or even like
kasi
taking
we learn
pictures.
From them, di ba, sir? We also learn from them, yung mga Gen Z.
The Gen Z, the selfie pictures,
yeah.
Yung mga ganon. So, like, oh, man. And then the language also is different, you know?
Ay, nako, sir. Totoo.
The language and the patience is totally a different thing.
Very true.
So,
sir, very quick. I'm sorry, sir. So you go on.
No, no, but it's important just to be open. It's always important to be open and just learn and take all the good things. And even, you know, and then learn from everything.
Mm-hmm. Sir, very quick. Very quick. How do you see yourself 5 to 10 years from now?
I think I'll still pursue and try to improve myself, learn more stuff, be more adventurous, and try to maximize whatever possibilities I have. Not only on performance, but producing, also for encouraging, also doing some seminars to encourage a lot of people to, you know, find themselves through art, music, performance.
And I hope one day na magkaroon kayo ng seminar or workshop, I'll be there.
Sure, of course.
Yeah, and sir, one last question. How important is your Tamasyan education to your totality as a performer and as a person?
Well, definitely, education is the key. Especially, I'm so proud to be in our university because it's a Catholic school. You know, there's a lot of like it's important to have a very strong position on your ideas, right? And then with the restriction and with the consideration, kasi maganda yung you're following a certain way. And I must say, like, you know, I've been in touch also with my batchmates. You know, it's always good. The camaraderie is still there, and then we have a, you know, I'm very proud of our Conservatory of Music because my colleagues are now professors, are doing well, and inspiring a lot of young students and making them excel, winning, working, studying abroad. And it's a totally big, big jump from when we started before. So,
yes, very proud. Diba yung kanta nga, diba? Ako ay isang Tomasino. Napaka-ganda ng interview. Naku, napaka-ikli ng oras natin para sa kwentuhan at talakayan natin ito kay Sir Elijah. Ang dami nating natutunan. And then, sir, kindly give your final message now to our viewers, especially to our aspiring young musicians and singers.
Yeah, it's just be open and it's important for us artists, musicians, teachers. It's not perfect. There's always a rejection. There's always like things that doesn't work. But don't give up. It's nothing to do about age, nothing to do about anything. But the drive should always be there, 100%, and always continue to inspire yourself and inspire others. Share the knowledge and gather, watch, be aware of your surroundings, be aware, be active, have a stand.
Yes, oh my gosh. One of the things that I like what you said about St. Augustine,
singing is twice powerful then, because I'm also a good singer in high school.
Oh, I see.
PSA.
So,
iba kasi kung tayo, kumakanta tayo, so when you're performing, when you're singing, even for teaching, kasi you put your, the sound combined together, it's a gift, it's a miracle, you know?
And the heart.
It heals.
Yeah. And yun, besides that, yung syempre, nandyan yung singing is like praying twice, and then yung discipline and openness to learning, yun yung mga things na nakuha ko ngayon, and for sure, madami ding nakuha ang ating listeners or ating viewers for today. So, sir,
I forgot one thing. Don't forget to pray and ask for guidance. No matter
Love
what.
That, sir. Yes, yes. Kasi at the end of the day, he really...
Because we can control our, no matter how much you plan your life, it's really up to him.
Yes, and that is why you are successful, sir, because you are, you know, lifting everything to him. Thank you so much, sir. Maraming salamat.
No, my pleasure. Thank you for inviting me.
for
yeah, I
joining
wish you all the
us.
Best and to all the people
yes.
who were part of it, for Chewy, from like sila John,
uh-huh.
and then I missed another name. I'm so bad. Si Ma'am Ida, yes.
Yes. Oh my gosh, maraming salamat po, sir. And looking forward to meet you in person. Thank
Same.
You for inspiring
okay.
us for
maraming
today.
Salamat po sa
inyo. Yes, sir. Thank you so much. So before we finally close the show, we have some important announcements. Calling all alumni associations of USP, the nomination for the Distinguished Tomasian Alumni is now on its tail end on August 31. This is on Sunday already. You still have a few days left to send in your nominations for this awards. Dear friends, thank you for joining us today. Do watch Bridges again on Tuesday for another exciting episode. It's sponsored by the USD Faculty of Pharmacy Alumni Foundation Incorporated. Do stay with us as we continue to share with you your blessings of Bridges. Subscribe to our USD Tomasian Alumni Community YouTube channel and Facebook page. The past episodes of Bridges can be watched in our YouTube. Here at Bridges, we do not build walls. We build connections to reach out to one another. We build strong bridges of faith, bridges of hope, and bridges of love. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Mabuhay!